Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Vanmali and welcome to the video lecture 3 of how to solve the problems of KL transform or Hotelling transform. So the question over here is to obtain the Hotelling transform given
x1 is 0 0 0 transpose, x2 is equal to 1 0 0 transpose, x3 is equal to 1 1 0 transpose, x4 is equal to 101 transform. Okay, so
one should remember Hotelling transform is nothing but the KL transform.
Now in the previous two problems I have given the complete details
steps of
how to carry out the calculation. So in this problem and the next problem, what I will give is briefly the important answer. I am expecting the student should carry out all the steps in detail.
And they should verify the answers with the what answers I am providing over here.
Okay. So over here, first what we'll do is we'll construct the image A that is composed of a vector x1, x2, x3 and x4. Okay. Now in the problem, they have given the row vectors along with the transpose. That means each of them is actually a column vector. So when you put these column vectors, okay, you will get your A as 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. And this is the corresponding A transpose, okay. So, each of those x1, x2 as a row vector will come over here, okay. And then corresponding A transpose, when you substitute the values, you will get it as 3, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, and 101. So it will be a 3x3 matrix over here. So when you find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, okay, there will be 3 eigenvalues for AA transpose
and there will be corresponding 3 eigenvectors. Okay. And now when you go for A transpose A, okay, and when you substitute A transpose and A over here, we will get a matrix something like this. Okay. So first row is all zeros, second row is 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. Third row is 0, 1, 2, 1. And the last row is 0, 1, 1, 2. So over here, A transpose A is a 4x4 matrix. So there will be 4 eigenvalues and the corresponding 4 eigenvectors. Okay. So if you find U, okay, columns of U will be normalized eigenvectors of A transpose. Okay. So we have already found what is AA transpose. So solve determinant AA transpose minus lambda I equal to 0. So substitute the AA transpose and you will get a determinant equation something like this. Okay, so find the equation and solve for it. Okay, so you will get the 3 eigenvalues like this. Okay, so I have already arranged them from the maximum to the minimum. Okay, so that is my lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda 3. Okay, so lambda 1 will be 3.7321, lambda 2 will be 1 and lambda 3 will be over here 0.2679. So for each of these lambdas, find the corresponding eigenvectors. Okay. So for each of the lambda, we will solve AA transpose minus lambda I x equal to 0. So when you solve for it and when you normalize it, you will get the first eigenvector as u1n, which is 0.8881, 0.3251, 0.3251. For the second eigenvalue, that is 1, you will get the normalized eigenvector as u2n, that is 0, minus 0.7071 and 0.7071. And for the third eigenvalue, you will get the vector as u3n, that is minus 0.4597. 0.6280, 0.6280, and correspondingly the matrix U, okay, which is comprising of 3 normalized eigenvectors, okay, that is U1n, U2n and U3n. So substitute and you will get a matrix U like this. Okay. Similarly, we will find the matrix V. So columns of V are normalized eigenvectors of A transpose A. Okay. So solve what is determinant A transpose A minus lambda I equal to 0. Okay. So here it is a 4 cross 4 matrix, so you will get 4 eigenvalues as lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 and lambda 4. And those values will be 3.7321, 1, 0.2679 and 0. Okay. Then for each lambda I, we will solve A transpose A minus lambda I x equal to 0. And correspondingly, we will get 4 eigenvectors. Okay, that is v1n, v2n, v3n and v4n. Okay, of course they are normalized. Okay, and then we will find the matrix V, okay, that is comprising of v1n, v2n, v3n and v4n. Okay, so you will get a 4 cross 4 matrix for V like this. Once you get this U and V, okay, again we can find the transform image, that is capital lambda, as U transpose A V. Okay, so substitute the values, perform the matrix multiplication, and this is what the final transformed image you will get. Again, as I said, you will have non-zero term only along the principal diagonal. Okay, and all the terms will be zero. So over here these terms are zero, and over here these three terms are zero. Okay, so this is my transformed image. Okay, there is another similar question over here, okay, to find the Hodling transform, and they have given the 4 vectors over here, that is x1, x2, x3 and x4. Okay, so again we can repeat the same steps. Okay, create A, which is composing of x1, x2, x3, x4, find the A transpose, find what is A transpose, sorry, find what is A transpose, which will be in this case again a 3 cross 3 matrix. Find A transpose A, which we again get a 4 cross 4 matrix over here. So there will be 3 eigenvalues and 3 eigenvectors corresponding to A transpose. And there will be 4 eigenvalues and corresponding 4 eigenvectors for A transpose A. Okay. So find U. So for that, find the eigenvalues of A transpose first. So these are the values over here. Then find the eigenvectors, normalize them and construct a matrix U. So I have given a matrix U over here that you should get. Similarly, for A transpose A, find the eigenvalues. So here you will get the 4 eigenvalues like this. And for each of these eigenvalue, find the corresponding eigenvector, normalize it. So you will have v1n, v2n, v3n and v4n as the 4 normalized eigenvectors. And then find out what is your matrix V, which will be a 4 cross 4 matrix like this. And once you get your U and V, you can find what is your capital lambda, that is transformed image as U transpose A V. Okay. So again, you will get a diagonal matrix like this. Okay, so follow all the steps what I explained earlier, okay, one by one, and verify that you again get a answer what I've shown over here. So this is your final transformed image. Thank you.